Hey everyone, this is just a quick video about how to differentiate the size of DNA when doing gel electrophoresis. I'll talk just a little bit about the structure of agarose and how that plays into DNA migration within the gel, and then I'll explain how to actually differentiate DNA sizes within your gel. So if you're just starting out with gel electrophoresis and want a quick explanation, stick around. Before we dive into understanding how to differentiate band sizes, we need to talk about the structure of agarose. And that plays a huge role in how DNA actually moves through a gel. To the naked eye, your gel is going to look smooth and gelatinous and a little opaque, basically like a gel. But if you look at this illustration here, this is just a conceptual rendering of agarose at more of a microscopic level. The structure is more of a mesh, and what that means is that different fragment sizes of DNA are going to move through that mesh at different rates. So for instance, if you had a smaller fragment of DNA, that's going to be able to travel through this porous mesh a lot easier than a larger fragment of DNA, because that larger fragment is going to get caught up in everything. Maybe an example to think about would be trying to get a couch through a doorway versus a chair, especially a small chair. So with that in mind, let's look at this illustration. Here we have a picture of a gel with three lanes. The first lane is just your DNA ladder, and then the next lane is sample one, and then the third lane, sorry, confusing, but that's sample two. In sample one, you see a band that has traveled further down the gel, and then in sample two, the fragment hasn't traveled quite as far. So the question is, which band is the larger fragment of DNA? Again, if we think about that couch versus chair scenario, the big bulky couch is going to have a harder time maneuvering than that small chair. The same thing happens with gel electrophoresis. During a set period of time that your gel is being ran, the smaller fragments are going to travel through the gel faster and therefore farther than the larger gel fragments. So in this example here, sample one, where the band has traveled further down, would be your smaller fragment of DNA. And sample two, where the fragment hasn't traveled quite as far, that's your larger fragment of DNA. Okay, so that's all well and good and fairly easy to understand, I hope. But what about the bands in that first lane, the ladder? In that first lane over there, this is your DNA ladder, and it has multiple fragment sizes of DNA. Each fragment of DNA in this ladder is of a known size. So for instance, you have 250 base pairs, 500 base pairs, 750 base pairs, and so on. And in just the same way, the smaller fragments in that ladder lane, they're going to appear a lot further down the lane than the larger fragments. And because the fragments of the ladder are of known sizes, they can be used to measure the bands in your other lanes. So if we compare sample one, which is in lane two, if we compare that to the ladder, we see that sample one is about 500 base pairs. But if we compare sample two over here with our ladder, we see that sample two is roughly 2,000 base pairs. So now that we kind of have a basic understanding of how this all works, let's do a quick quiz. I've got another example here. And in this case, there's four lanes. The first is your ladder, and then there's the other lanes, which are samples one through three. The first exercise is just to see if you can put the lanes in order, not counting the ladder lane, but in order from the lane with the smallest fragment to the lane with the largest fragment. The correct order is sample three is the smallest, sample one would be the next, and then sample two is the largest. The next exercise then is to look at this example and use the DNA ladder in lane one to determine the approximate size of the bands in lanes two through four. So based on the ladder, sample three is about 200 base pairs, sample one is about 500 base pairs, and sample two is about 1,000 base pairs. So just to sum everything up when talking about electrophoresis, there's a few points to make. The first thing is that because of the structure of agarose, DNA is going to move at different rates through the gel based on its size. The next important point is that the larger DNA fragments move slower through the gel and therefore do not travel as far down a lane during a given runtime. And because smaller DNA fragments can move quickly through the gel, they're going to travel a lot further down a lane in that given runtime. Finally, a DNA ladder shows multiple bands of a known size to enable you to measure the size of your DNA that you're working with. I hope you found this information helpful. If so, help us out by hitting that like button and subscribing for more content like this. And don't forget also to check out goldbio.com for more resources and find high quality reagents there. Thank you all so much for watching. See you again.